stronger. And I've directed we pause and reduce personnel expenditures, capital expenditures, and operational expenditures for the remainder of 2020. We're going to be strategic and adaptive and take a wait-and-see approach in preparing the 2021 budget. We've always worked together to pass prudent budgets in good days, which benefits us more in challenging days like today. And now I'll have Maureen and Tanji provide an overview presentation on the budget approach moving forward.
At this time, and this is what I'll spend most of the presentation on with estimates, is at this time there is no funding mechanism to make up for any revenue losses due to the COVID-19. So in total, we have estimated roughly 12.76 million revenue decline in 2020 as compared to 2019. Please know that we will be monitoring this and continue to monitor this as more information becomes available. I can't stress that enough. There will be a lag time, as you know, with sales tax collections versus when those sales occur. For instance, we'll receive sales tax collections in May and June for sales that took place in March and April. So what we've received to date in April takes us through sales through the month of February. Much of the impact of state aid won't be known until second quarter collections come in, which we receive in July. Utility revenue will be monitored, and we will be looking at that monthly. Right now, you can see that we have made certain assumptions with these revenue impacts. We've assumed at this time a 25% revenue decrease in our state aid, sales tax, gas tax. Like I said, we will continue to monitor this.